This video is intended to describe the Modulog cedar siding system and how it is installed. Modulog siding is milled from a select grade of dried cedar lumber and is used for remodeling as well as new construction. Its patented solid log corner feature gives the true log look and feel to any site build or manufactured home. We will describe each phase of a typical Modulog siding application separately, so that you can go directly to the part of the installation process of interest to you at the time. About half of Modulog installations are done by the homeowner, perhaps with the help of a friend or relative. The other half doesn't have the time or inclination and hires a local contractor to perform the work. This video will guide the homeowner through each phase of the job and will also familiarize the contractor with the few construction techniques that differ from ordinary siding installation. So that the correct amount of siding is delivered to your site, the total square footage to be covered is needed. Multiply the width times the height of each wall and add these figures to obtain the total square footage of the walls. Gable square footage is found by multiplying the length of the gable by the height at the peak and dividing this figure by 2. Add gable totals to wall totals. Next, find the square footage of each door and window. Add totals and subtract this figure from the total figure of the walls and gables. We now have the total square footage of the walls and gables to be covered. From this figure, Modulog can calculate the lineal feet of siding needed for the job, along with an appropriate waste factor. To determine the number of log ends needed, simply measure the height in inches of each corner of the house where crisscrossing log corners are desired. Measured from where the siding starts, at the bottom, to where it stops under the eaves. These measurements allow Modulog to ship the right number of corner assemblies. Half will be rights and half will be lefts. Modulog provides a number of rustic trim items that eliminate the need to fabricate these pieces on the job. Besides speeding up the job, their rustic design enhances the final look of your home. Take note of the number of trim items you need, such as outside fixtures, electrical outlets, dryer vents, hose bibs, inside corners, and vents. On smaller homes and manufactured homes, log ends on the four corners of the home are usually all that is needed to give an authentic log appeal. Larger homes have other corners such as entranceways, alcoves, and jog outs where log ends either restrict space or would give a log overkill look. For these areas, Modulog offers an optional corner trim. If optional corner trim is needed for your project, add it to your trim list. Modulog siding needs to be fastened through the sheathing into the studs. On new construction, the studs are easy to find and mark. The studs under T111 or panel siding on manufactured homes are easy to locate. Remodeling applications on site built homes may present situations where Modulog siding is applied over a thicker substrate. If the underlying material is at least 3/4 inch thick, it is stable enough to hold fasteners, eliminating the need to find the studs. Sometimes houses are not perfectly level, especially manufactured homes. For this reason, it is necessary to snap a reference line so that the siding is applied square with the house. Measure down from the underside of the eaves at each corner of the house to a point where the top of the first course of the siding will be. Connect these points with a snapped line. This ensures that the siding is installed level with the roof line of the home. After the location of the studs and the reference line has been marked, the placement of trim comes next. Remove light fixtures, existing trim, shutters, and vents. Take down other items such as phone boxes, satellite dish mountings, etc. that need to be removed and reinstalled after the log siding is up. Fixture bases, outlet trim, hose bib trim, dryer vent trim, vents, and any other mounting blocks that may be needed are set in place. These trim pieces can be toenailed in place with small nails which will be hidden when the siding is installed. Also, the final caulking, when cured, will hold the trim pieces firmly in place. Miter cuts at inside corners never seem to match properly. This detracts from the finished look of the job and can allow moisture penetration. Modulog inside corner trim eliminates the need to miter cut the siding and seals the joint with nice square cuts. For tight joints on the window trim, it is best assembled on a flat surface rather than installed one leg at a time. Make the inside dimensions 1/4 inch larger than the window frame. This leaves a 1/8 inch space around the window frame that is caulked with silicone. wiring, piping, and service boxes, etc., can be boxed with 1x4s or trimmed out with 2x2s as the case requires. Modulog siding and corner assemblies are shipped in waterproof lumber wrap and will arrive at the building site dry. Keep the siding dry throughout the building process. In hot, dry weather, don't leave the siding laying about as some pieces may warp. Pull siding from the stack as needed and keep the stack covered or in shade if possible. For fasteners, use 2-inch stainless steel staples with a 7/16 inch crown. This, of course, requires an air compressor, but the time saved is well worth it. The advantage of staples is that when the crowns are driven lengthwise with the grain of the wood, they virtually disappear. 10D or 12D hot dip galvanized casing nails can be used in place of staples as their heads leave smaller holes than common nails or screws. Nail clips are available for use with an air compressor. Two fasteners are driven into each stud, one near the top and one near the bottom. Butt joints are staggered, at least two studs apart. Butt joints should fall on a stud using two fasteners at each end of the siding. When installing over a substrate at least 3/4 inch thick, it is not necessary to hit the studs. And if you are using nails for fastening, a smaller size is used. Care should be taken to make square cuts so that the butt joints fit tightly together. The horizontal seams of each course of the Modulog siding is set tightly, shoulder to shoulder, with the course below. No expansion gap is needed. The first piece of siding is placed parallel with the reference line and flush with the corner of the building. A corner assembly, right or left as the case may be, is set in place, making sure it fits its mate snugly. Continue this course to the opposite corner of the house, keeping on the reference line. The butt joints are sealed with a bead of caulking before they are slid together. It is important to keep the siding seams on each side of the door and window trims the same height so that the seams match the top of the door or window. It is a rare wall that is divisible by exactly 7-inch increments. This means the last course of siding under the soffit will most likely have to be ripped to somewhat less than 7 inches to fit. A corner assembly is not used here. Instead, a 45-degree miter cut is used at these corners. To represent stacked logs, each end of a course of siding must be placed in the proper butt and pass configuration. When the corner assembly are placed correctly on the first course, the rest will fall in order. During the installation of the siding, the only caulking to be done is between the butt joints. Now that the job is completed, it's time to give your job the finishing touch with a nice smooth bead of caulk around the trim and log ends. Caulking not only prevents moisture penetration, but also hides forever any less than perfect cuts around the various trim pieces. A polyurethane sealant like Vulcum 116 is used with Modulog siding, and a buff or tan color blends well with the cedar tones. Caulking colors never seem to match the wood perfectly, but the caulk will pick up the color next time you stain. If you haven't had a lot of experience with the caulking gun, it's good advice to start at the back of the house. By the time you get around to the front, you'll be an expert. The wood should be dry for the caulking material to create an effective moisture seal. With Modulog siding, it is not necessary to caulk the horizontal seams. The 1/2-inch weather lap keeps the water out. Cut the spout of the caulking tube at the point that leaves a 1/4-inch bead of caulk. Modulog trim is thicker than the siding, giving you a shoulder to caulk against, making it easier to get a smooth, uniform bead. To avoid any smears, never wipe off excess caulking with a rag. Wait for it to dry and trim the excess with a utility knife. If you followed the previous instructions carefully, your Modulog siding installation will go together smoothly. This concludes the video instructions.